Now where we can find the possible source for the water. So there are two types of sources, as you can see on the slide. The first one is called the surface source. The other part is called the subsurface source or the underground source. When it comes to the surface source, whatever the amount of the water which is available on the surface, is said to be a surface source. For example, stream, lakes, river, oceans, impounded reservoir, ponds, and stored rainwater. These are the all possible surface sources which are available. While on the other hand, if you can see, there is a surface source or the underground source. Water which is available below the ground level is said to be the underground source. For example, spring, wells, infiltration galleries, and infiltration wells. Now, if you can see the next slide, this slide is clearly shows the pictorial representation of the surface sources. The first one is the seawater, river, lake, and ponds. Now, what is the surface source? Flow over the surface of the earth and is directly available for the water supplies like natural pond, lake, river, and streams. Okay, most of the earth's water surface get their waste supply from the precipitation, that is the rainfall, which may fall in the various forms such as rain, snow, hail, dew, etc. For all the natural water supplies, the rainwater is the major principal source for the resultant supplies. Okay? When it comes to the surface sources, what is meant by the spring? Spring is nothing but the natural outflow of the groundwater at the earth's surface. It is said to form a spring. If you would like to define what exactly is the meaning of spring, spring is nothing but a natural outflow of the groundwater at the surface of the earth. It is said to be spring. For example, spring has a further more type. First one is the gravity spring, second is the surface spring. What happening is the gravity spring. Why the spring is said to be a gravity? For example, as you can see in this diagram, this is the natural water level and this is the natural layer of the soil. Now because of the precipitation, the water will get percolate to this pervious layer and will get settled on the layer of the water. And with this continuous percolation of the liquid particles, the particles will travel towards the water level and at some point, due to the presence of the gravity, due to the natural pressure of this water, the water will get outflow out of this ground level, which is called as the spring, as I already said, natural outflow of the groundwater at the surface of the earth. But how it is coming out of the ground? It is coming out because of the gravity. Hence, it is said to be the gravity spring. What is the difference between the gravity spring and the surface spring? Why the surface spring is not a gravity spring? Okay, if you can see this diagram. There is an impervious layer before the groundwater table. As in the earlier case, there was precipitation and the water particle percolated to this pervious layer and will meet the groundwater level. Then, because of the gravity, it is coming out of the earth. It is hence into gravity spring. But in the surface layer, this is formed when the impervious stratum is supporting the groundwater level. The impervious layer is supporting the groundwater reservoir, also said to be the water bearing rock formation. What exactly is happening here is because of the rainfall, the layer of this water will get increased, and because it is getting increased, and at one point of the time it will fall out of this impervious layer. Hence, because of this impervious layer, because of the presence of the impervious layer, the water is called the spring, formed is called the surface spring. Now, there are various types of the spring. The first spring is called the artesian spring. Now, what exactly mean by the artesian spring? Spring formed under some confined aquifer oozes out under pressure. The springs are formed because of confined, for example, the water is stored between the impervious layer and the pervious layer. Whatever the water is here is called as the aquifer. And because of the infiltration area, there will be the pressure, there will be the chance of this water to get leveled up. Okay? And because of this pressure, if there is present a small gap on this impervious, the water will ooze out under pressure. Okay? So this whatever the spring form because of such case is called as the artesian spring. So for example, if I show this video.
You see this handle? It's popping water out. seeps down into the soil and is stored as groundwater. So the hand pump was pumping out this groundwater. Now there is a name for this process through which the water passes down to the soil, and that is known as infiltration. This infiltrated water accumulates in a deep underground. At its point, where a layer of impermeable rocks are there. By definition, impermeable rocks don't permit the water to seep down any further. And these places that have impermeable layer of rocks are known as aquifers. Have you heard of them before? So due to infiltration of rainwater or water from the bodies, it passes through the porous soil and recharges around water. And this water in the aquifers is what is pumped up using this water pump.
Time came that the water may get dried up